The art of bluegrass playing really lies within the precise control of your flat picking. Now, flat picking is just your downstrokes and your upstrokes, any combination of those as you play through your lines. And this creates a real powerful sound in bluegrass. In fact, a lot of the lines that you'll be learning throughout this course, you could play using fingerstyle, you could play using hybrid picking as well, but you won't get the same phrasing, you won't get that same bluegrass sound that you're just used to hearing. So what we'll do is talk about the downstroke first. As you play through the string, the first thing you want to realize is that you're pushing through. You're holding the pick between your thumb and your first finger. Now your first finger, you actually want to curl it underneath to create a base. Alright, you want a real strong foundation here so that when you put your thumb flat across, you're actually pushing downward and the pick won't fall out of your hand either. So when you push down, you want to come to rest on the string below. Real important, you don't want to flick the pick out. Alright, you also don't want to use too much of your elbow when you do this either. A lot of the motion here is going to come from just the thumb pushing down and also a little bit of your wrist as well. You can go through the fifth string, down to the fourth string, and just practice that motion of that one stroke going through. Go for powerful sounds. Keep your volume very consistent. Okay, so now we'll do some down up strokes as well, just to practice that technique. Now, if you notice, I'm getting the same sound, roughly the same sound in my upstroke as in my downstroke. You also want to experiment with the pick. You don't want to come in straight on the string here and play straight down and hold so tight that the pick doesn't move. You'll get a really harsh sound that way. What you want to do is hold it just enough so that you get some flex as you push through. And then when you pull up with your first finger, you're getting a little bit of flex that way as well. Okay, you'll get a much smoother sound, and you'll be able to play quicker and more accurate on the strings. So what we'll do now is we'll take a look at your first example. And we're going to make use of this downstroke here. I followed through into the next string. Real important, that follow through is everything. And then we'll do some alternate strokes now as well. The last thing I want to mention here as I go through these is that you want to roll your pick down just a little bit. You don't want to come straight in against the string. Roll it down slightly and also bend your thumb forward a little bit so that you tilt the pick forward. It's kind of like a pitch and roll kind of thing. And this allows you to slide and cut right through the string. And you can control your volume. You can control how accurate you'll be. You'll know exactly where the string is every time. If you come in and hold the pick too harshly here, too hard, I can't even really push with my thumb here. I gotta use my elbow, and it's creating a really harsh sound. So if you play this way, you'll still get a powerful sound, but you'll be sensitive to the string as well, which will make it more accurate and faster.